welcome to the show. I am your host, Babby Mason, and thank you so very much for joining me for a wonderful show. I have an extraordinary guest who is going to join me in just a little bit. She is a timeless, timeless singer, and you'll recognize her face as being one of those mainstays on the Bill Gaither Homecoming family recordings and DVDs and live concerts. And she has an extraordinary tenure in music ministry, over 40 years of being in the music ministry, and you will hear her story tonight. She is none other than the incomparable Lily Knowles. You're going to meet her in just a moment and hear her incredible story, and she's going to sing. And if you'll stick around, we have a surprise for you nearing the end of our show. You don't want to miss that, so stay tuned for a wonderful show. Listen, I want to sing for you tonight, and I am just so grateful that we have the opportunity to go into the house of the Lord. The Bible says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. So I'm going to sing two songs for you. One is called Stop by the Church, and what a beautiful song of praise it is. And the second song is called The Lord is Here. And whatever you are experiencing today, whatever is going on in your world, whatever anxiety you might be experiencing, wherever there is lack or anxiety, the Lord is with you. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 and 7, be anxious for nothing, but in all things by prayer and supplication, let your requests be made known unto God, and the peace that passes all understanding will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. So will you just worship with me as I sing these two songs? Let's worship together.
Well, you ought to stop by the church sometime. Stop by the church sometime. Well, something may be said to help you on your way. When you stop by the church sometime, you ought to stop by the church sometime. Listen to the songs that they sing. Well, the words of a song will help you to carry on. If you stop by the church sometimes, then you can listen to the prayers that they pray. Listen to the prayers that they pray. You there when you stop by the church sometimes. Now, when you see the preacher come out and take a stand, read the Holy Scripture, you ought to try and take it in. In that Holy Bible, it's got everything you need. You can find a scripture for every description. Yeah. When you take a little time and read, you ever feel lonely? Talked about.
Stop by the church.
Oh, that's all right.
Stop by the church.
wherever you are in your world, in your life, God says, I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you, but I'm with you even until the end of the age. In these holy moments, God is moving by His grace. I can see the glory of His presence on each face. In the beauty of holiness, no other name compares to our God, to our God. The Lord is here, the Lord is here. He is awesome in this place, the Lord is here.
There are so many things in the world today that quickly become obsolete. It seems like what was brand new yesterday is obsolete by today, or at the very best next week or next month. But I want to tell you for just a few seconds about an absolute that is not and never will be obsolete, and that is the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. 2,000 years ago, His blood began to flow on Calvary's cross, and it saved then and it still saves today. You know, the Bible tells us that we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ cleanses us from all unrighteousness. The Apostle Paul said in Ephesians 1:7 that we have redemption by His blood and the forgiveness of sins. Can I tell you, it doesn't matter who you are, what you've done, where you're from, His blood still cleanses. It's the absolute that is not obsolete. I love you today. I'll see you again in just a minute.
Well, welcome back to the show. Today's guest has been warming the hearts of friends and family and followers for almost 40 years, maybe close to 50 years in ministry. And she has an impeccable ministry and career. She has been ministering literally around the world as one of the original Edwin Hawkins singers. You might remember back in the year 1970, if you can go back that far, a powerful hit that not only blasted on gospel radio, but also it crossed over into secular radio, that unforgettable song called "Oh Happy Day." Well, our guest was an original member of the Edwin Hawkins Singers and is on that recording and has literally sung that song behind Edwin Hawkins around the world up until his passing. And now the Lord has given her a beautiful ministry. She is a part of the Bill Gaither Homecoming family. And I think if I'm correct, that's where we met. And we have become fast friends. And more than that, we are sisters in the Lord. Let me introduce to you who are watching the incomparable, the impeccable, the unforgettable, the beautiful. I cannot find enough superlatives to introduce this beautiful lady, Lily Knowles. Oh. Lily, my friend, thank you for being on the show with me.
Like I'm at Babby's house.
You are at Babby's house. You are in my heart, and you are in my house. And you're in my house because your music is in my house. I've been playing your music all week.
Well, yeah, that was 26 years ago we met at the Gaithers. Wow. That's how long I was on there.
That's right. Yeah. Well, let's talk about that. How did you meet Mr. Bill Gaither? How did you become a part of that whole wonderful family that we get to be a part of?
Do you remember their musical, Alleluia?
Yes.
Well, I was living in San Jose, and a big church wanted to have the Bay Area premiere of Alleluia. Asked me to come and sing God Gave the Song and one other song. Well, the gentleman who was there to do many of the other songs was Doug Oldham.
Doug Oldham. He recorded one of my songs, All Right.
I know, right? Oh, when he sang that at the taping, it was awesome. So he said afterward, I need to tell two friends about you. Well, his friends were Bob McKenzie and Bill Gaither.
Wow. They don't come any finer than those two gentlemen.
So I was sitting at my desk on my job, and my supervisor came and said, there's somebody on the phone named Bill Gaither. Would you like to speak with him? That was like saying the President of the United States is calling.
Yes, of course.
So I went over there, and he said, Gloria and I are starting a record company in Nashville, and we would like you to be one of the first artists. Would you like to? So I flew down there, and the rest is history. And then I traveled when it was Bill, Gloria, and Danny as the Bill Gaither Trio.
Of course.
I traveled with them. And it was just a wonderful introduction by the Lord and the connection.
Yes. Well, we love you by what we can see on screen, but I want to go back. I want to go back to your childhood, because we don't know a lot about your beginning and where you were born and about your family. So tell us a little bit about growing up.
Well, my mom had 5 children, 1 year apart. She waited 6 years, and I was born. So that's why everybody says I'm spoiled rotten, because they were...
Because you are.
And it was a wonderful Christian home. I thank God for my mom that was the home I was born into. Every time the church door opened, the Knowles family walked through. 6 girls, 1 boy. And I was always at church. Of course, you know, the choir is the focal point of the church. And I was in the choir from the time I was able to sing. I thought that I could sing. And ended up playing for the choir, not like you, but it was interesting now that I looked back.
You're really kind.
And growing up, and I remember the day that I realized that I needed Jesus, and that my mom said that that's what we needed to get to heaven, was to accept Jesus, and I did, and many, many, many years later, He's still in my heart.
Yes. So where were you born?
Fort Smith, Arkansas.
Oh, wonderful. Fort Smith, Arkansas.
When I was 12, my dad passed away, and my mom had a sister in Seattle, and she said, I want you to bring the 2 girls out here, because I had a sister a year younger than me. we moved to Seattle, and it was the first time I went to an integrated school. That was interesting. I had never even seen an Asian person until I got to Seattle and got a part of a wonderful church there and in the choir, and it was just been a wonderful life.
Wow.
Thank God.
Well, you know what? I don't know that I've ever had this opportunity to say this, but let me just say this publicly. Thank you. Thank you for being a trailblazer. Thank you for introducing wonderful music. Thank you for being a shining light for the cause of Christ. And I can remember when I was in about the 9th or the 10th grade back in the mid-70s and, you know, the late 60s and early 70s, playing the piano for my father's church, and I heard this song on the radio.
I know.
Called Oh Happy Day with that familiar do-do-do-do in the piano part. Yeah. I mean, it was just a setup for a little preacher's girl like me, you know, to go to the piano and pick out those words and that melody. And the next thing I know, I was teaching it to the choir, and that song just, it blew up all over the world, literally.
It still is. I have to do it every concert. Nobody seems to get tired of it.
No, it's...
And I tell the people, if you look in the hymn book, if you can find one at a church, but I mean, it's in the hymn book. It's an old hymn.
Yes.
Edmund Rearranged brought it to rehearsal that night and said, I went through the hymn book and I saw a song and taught it to us and we sang it. And
what was that like? What was it like? I mean, you know, when you're working, you don't really realize, you know, how great of a moment you're establishing pretty much until people pass away, and then you kind of realize that was a pretty big deal.
Yes.
But how did you become a member of the Edwin Hawkins Singers?
Well, I belonged to a great church in San Jose, 32 miles from Oakland. And they said there was going to be rehearsal for a choir that was going to go back east to compete in a singing whatever. And if we wanted to be a part of the choir. So my friends and I, we drove up every Monday night to Oakland to rehearse and went back and came in second in the competition. Then we recorded that album. And the interesting things, it was an Ampex two tracks. So Dorothy's on one track and the choir's on another. And took the photo, made the recording. A year later, a hippie named Abe was throwing away records.
In case y'all don't know what a hippie is.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You tell her.
Well, a hippie is like a, you know, a long-haired person that's kind of free-spirited,
yeah,
you know, and just kind of lives by the whims and enjoys life and maybe lives what we would call off the grid,
yes,
you know, just a free spirit.
That's right. He's throwing away records in the back room of a warehouse in San Francisco. He sees the picture of the black choir, puts it on the turntable. The first cut is Oh Happy Day. He flipped out, ran down to a radio station, said, you got to play this.
Wow, and the rest is history.
That's how it happened. The rest is history.
That is amazing. You know, I've traveled a lot overseas, and particularly in Europe. Mm-hmm. When they hear this song, Oh Happy Day, it's like the national anthem of the continent. And every time when I've gone overseas and taken singers with me and we sing Oh Happy Day kind of like the end of our concert, because we know Europeans love this song and really around the world, we have to do two and three
encores,
and four encores.
Encores, that's right.
What is it about this song that is just unforgettable?
I think it was different than the music that was then. And there is a message, even people who didn't know Jesus as Lord, it was just exciting to think that there is somebody who can save us, and God used it. It was a mystery to us.
It is a mystery how God uses this song.
That's
even for people that don't know the Lord, it's a connection.
That's right.
To this song, and it's powerful.
Yeah.
Well, I want to know, you've been singing for how many years now?
Well, my first recording was 1975, so that's 85, 95, 205, 215.
Wow.
40-something years.
40-something years.
Almost 50 years.
Almost 50 years.
Because I sang before I had a record. Remember records?
Yes, I remember records.
Yes, I had.
Uh-huh. That's like a granddaddy CD. And for those of y'all that don't know what a CD is, just ask your grandmother.
I sang before I even had a record. And so it was before 75, yes.
Yeah. So what do you think, you know, a lot of people... You know, you're a few years older than I am, but according to categories, we're kind of like in the same, we're not in the same decade, but we're in the same category.
We can say
95 plus tax, shipping and handling.
I'm 83.
You're 83. Miss Lily Knowles, that is unbelievable.
Well, it's true.
It's true. And listen, you're gorgeous. You are just gorgeous and stunning. And a whole lot of things that
I
can say.
But I never get asked out on a date. Ever.
That was going to be my question. You've been singing for a long time and you never married.
Never
married. You've always been single.
Yes.
And there are people who are watching that are wondering, you know, does... I don't know how to deal with my singleness. Does God have a mate for me? You know, you hear people say, well, you're looking for your better half, you know, things like that. How do you, talk to us about being single all these years.
Well, I almost married. I had my wedding invitations, a ring, everything, but I knew that it was not God's will. And I did not want to do that, knowing that I would be out of the will of God. So I canceled everything.
Yeah.
And then I realized that God had a plan for me, and I just started traveling after that. And I'm thinking now, it would have been difficult, I believe, to have done what I have done and gone where I've gone had I been married.
Yes.
And with children. So,
yes.
And I try to tell singles that you have to be happy. The state, as Paul said, the state that you're in, be content. And I'm not talking about Washington or Oregon. I'm talking about the state that you're in, be content. Because find happiness where you are and let God use you. And singles are able to do things that married people can't do as far as helping out in the church and with ministries. And I say to people that if you are single and you're unhappy, you will be unhappy when you're married. Because happiness does not come from a person. It comes from God. It comes from Jesus.
Yes.
And so
and happiness is...
Happenings.
It's situated upon our happenings.
Yes.
But joy...
Jesus.
Is from Jesus.
That's right.
Because joy is a person.
That's right.
And that person is Jesus. Well, I want to talk about the fact that you... when a lot of your counterparts and your peers and people your age have are sitting on the rocking chair and... watching Jeopardy and The Price is Right. You packed your bag. Listen, you live on the West Coast. And you just got here a couple of days ago, so you're still in, you know, changing time zones and traveling on long flights and getting up on stage and remembering all your words. And
not all the time.
Well, you know, reasonably so. I think you're doing pretty good, Miss Lily. I think you're doing really well. So talk to me about, you know, the fact that you haven't retired, but you've refired in a great sense of the word. And talk about the longevity of your career and your ministry.
Well, I owe it all to the Lord, and I spend as much time as I can in His Word because I know that's what refreshes me. And I know that He has this plan for me, and I want to go with it until I don't sing anymore. Then I won't sing anymore. But I'm not planning. People ask me, when are you going to retire? Go retire to what?
For what?
Yes.
Exactly. To
I
what?
I did move into a retirement center, though, 5 years ago. And that's been good for me because I can just lock the door and leave. And you know how little old neighbors are. Everybody's watching in my place, so I don't have to worry about...
There's a sense of security
there. Yes. I don't have to worry about anything.
That's good.
So it's just it's wonderful. I was so sad during COVID in 2020 that I wasn't able to be out and about. And so now that things are kind of lifting, I'm just going all the time now.
That's wonderful. Well, you are still singing, and your voice is stunning. I've been listening to you sing during our sound check. And your voice is absolutely gorgeous. And listen, one of my favorite memories is of you and me. We recorded a song together on one of the Gaither vocal, the Gaither videos.
And we're going to sing it.
We're going to sing
it. End.
Well, she just let the cat out of the bag. That's okay. That's okay. So you have to stick around for that. You don't want to miss this duet with Lily and me. It's going to be really beautiful.
It was a good time.
It was a good time. It was
a
wonderful time.
I love your voice.
And that's what I was going to say to you. Just complimenting you on the power and the clarity of your voice. How do you keep your voice so clear?
Well, I try not to sing, and you said this to me, and I've remembered it, above my range. If I can't go there comfortably, then I don't go there because I want to preserve what God has given me.
Well, He has definitely done that. You've taken really good care of your voice and yourself, and I'm just so so proud of you, and you're just gorgeous on the inside and mm-hmm. out. So you're still traveling. Are you still traveling and doing concerts? And
yes.
Tell us about that.
Often. When anybody calls, if I have it open, then I pray about it, and then I go. I'm just always on the plane, or I drive a lot of places, too.
You're still driving?
Yes, yes. And I love it, because I listen to tapes of ministry and songs and
yes.
as I'm going.
Yes. So talk to me about how the Lord has sustained you spiritually. You gave your heart to the Lord when you were just a young girl, mm-hmm. and so you've walked with the Lord for many years
yeah,
now.
Yeah.
And is there a passage of scripture or, you know, when you, that your heart can go to when, you know, you're challenged or you're disappointed or you need a word of encouragement? Talk to us about one of those life verses that continues to sustain you.
That he says he'll never leave me nor forsake me. And he'll always be there. Isaiah, was it 43:2? When I walk through the water, he's going to be with me. I'm not going to drown. When I walk through the fire, I'm not going to burn. He is always going to be by my side. And my time with the Lord in the mornings, I just can't leave the house without having time with him.
Yes.
And that sustains me and helps me all through the day.
Yes, it does. It does sustain you.
Uh-huh.
And it sustains me.
Uh-huh.
And you know, I am a mentor to up-and-coming singers and writers and do seminars and workshops uh-huh. and things like that, and been in ministry 36 years, and I don't see, you know, there's no expiration date on God's plan for your life, right? So what would you say to those, I mean, you have a long established career, you're still singing, you're speaking, you're ministering, and not just to, you know, people your age, but you get to minister to the world, because I go to the grocery store and I see people of all ages that recognize, you know, they may recognize my face from the Bill mm-hmm. Gaither homecoming mm-hmm. videos, and so they recognize you.
Yeah.
People from all generations. Mm-hmm. So what would you say to those who are up and coming who want to get started in the music ministry?
The first thing I say is to make sure that God is calling you. That's very important, because if you just see us up on stage and you think that's where I want to be, that will not work. You
yeah.
have to know that God has called you, and he's going to open every door that he wants you to walk through, and be comfortable with what he gives you to do, because it may change a
right.
little bit or something.
Yes. You know, one of your trademark characteristics is your smile. When that camera pans through that homecoming family, and you know, I might be sitting over there and you might be sitting on the other side of the, you know, the choir mm-hmm. loft or the group up there on stage, I can always look at Lily and you have that beautiful, impeccable mm-hmm. smile. Where does that deep smile, joy, contentment come from? Tell us about that.
Well, I say it's just Jesus' joy. I'm thankful that I know him as Lord and Savior. I'm thankful that he is always by my side. He never leaves me nor forsakes me. And I'm thankful that I can call on him when I have a need, whatever the need is. He knows about it. And he knows what I need when I need it. So that's why this 2020 of not being able to go out, and because singing is what I do, didn't have the income, but I never missed paying one bill.
Isn't that amazing? That's my story too.
People sent money to PayPal, and I was just, it was wonderful how I was taken care of.
Yes.
Didn't bother me, because the Lord promised that he would take care of me.
Yes.
He does.
And he's doing a good job of it. May I say, he's doing a good job of taking care of you.
You are.
So what are you going to sing for us tonight? You're going to sing Oh Happy Day.
Oh, yes.
You got to sing Oh Happy Day.
Absolutely.
Because that's just a song that everybody knows. And if you don't
know it,
it's real easy to learn.
Yeah.
And you'll just be tapping your toe and clapping your hands right in the middle of this
yeah.
wonderful song. So you're going to sing Oh Happy Day, and what else?
And then another song that it's an old hymn, but it just... It's about a story in the Bible, so it'll be coming across as
yes.
something.
Well, listen, Miss Lily, thank you for being so faithful to God and for being so steadfast in ministry. Amen. And we just wish and pray for God many more years of ministry for you.
Amen.
And I'm looking forward to seeing you on stage when we get together for another Bill Gaither homecoming, whenever that is. If not, we'll just watch the old videos, okay, or the old DVDs.
I know.
And thank God for
our
kinship.
And I can come to Babby's house.
You can come to Babby's house. You can come to my real house.
Yeah.
You can come to my real house and my show too. Oh. It doesn't matter. You're always welcome. The door is always open to you.
Well,
you're going to sing for us.
Yes.
And you're going to sing, Oh Happy Day.
Yeah.
And then Jesus came.
Mm-hmm.
So grab your microphone and we will look forward to talking with you some more. Ladies and gentlemen, Lily Knowles.
I want you to think about when Jesus came into your heart and life. It was a happy day, right? Yeah. Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day.
When Jesus was.
Aren't you glad he was? The Lord saved you. Everything was new and different after that. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says that when we're in Christ, we are a new creature. And here's this beautiful song. It's a hymn that talks about what happens when Jesus comes into a heart and life. One sat alone beside the highway begging. His eyes were blind, the light he could not see. He clutched his rags and he shivered in the shadows. Then Jesus came and he made his darkness flee. And this is for you. And when Jesus
comes. The tempters at Satan's power is broken. You see, when Jesus comes, every tear is wiped away. Here's what he does. He takes the gloom and then he fills a life with glory. For all is changed. Yes, it is. When Jesus comes to stay. I want to say it one more time. Let him take your gloom, all of it, and let him fill your life with glory and gladness and glory and gladness, for all is changed. You hear what I said? Everything is changed. All things are passed away and everything is changed. Yes, it is. All that happens when Jesus Christ comes into a heart and a life to stay.
Oh, I know you were blessed, and you are being blessed by this beautiful ministry of Lily Knowles and our wonderful conversation. And I'm just going to let her catch her breath here for a second. But I know her heart is to minister to you. And I don't know what you're going through right now, but I'm hoping and praying that the ministry, the music, the word, the conversation is ushering peace and well-being into your life. Miss Lily Knowles, you are such a blessing. Thanks for singing for us today.
Thank you for having me.
You know, as you were singing, I was just imagining that you, in almost 50 years, you've probably been around the world a few times and sung on...
57 countries.
57 countries. Wow, that's amazing. What is one of the highlights of traveling and... I mean, you've probably sung for presidents and kings and queens, and you've sung to the world on the Bill Gaither homecoming videos and DVDs. What's a highlight for you?
Ooh, probably Rio. There were 250,000 that day, and that was...
250,000 people?
Yes, yes.
Wow. What is it like knowing that as you sing, somebody is... getting in touch with the Lord,
yes.
Somebody is coming to know Jesus, somebody's body may be racked with pain, and mm-hmm. when you minister, they experience healing in their
That's
body.
Right.
I mean, you are a woman of great faith,
mm-hmm.
and you have walked with the Lord many years. What is that like, knowing that your ministry is impacting people spiritually, mentally, physically, emotionally, and that God is still using you even after 50 years of ministry?
It's wonderful because I know that he's flowing through me. I'm not doing anything. He's the one who's doing it. And I get excited to think that somebody who came in thinking they weren't going to make it, now when I say his eyes on the sparrow, he's watching over you, and they realize it's true.
Yes. Well, as I watch you minister, you are just... impeccable in your presentation.
Oh,
your
so kind.
Your voice. Oh, really? I mean, listen, I want to be like you when I grow up. I want to be like you. I want to be in my 80s and still packing my bag and driving to my concerts. What in the world? That's amazing. So do you have a... Listen, I've kind of been taking notes on you. Well, you have a website, you're online, you email, you text. I mean, you're just savvy in technology, and where a lot of people are a little intimidated
I was. It took me forever. My friends would say, this is ridiculous. You've got to get on this. And so finally, with help, it set up. And now I sort of kind of take care of it myself.
You take care of it yourself. Are you checking that out, y'all? She says, I take care of it myself. I love that. I want to talk a little bit more about that, Miss Lily, because things like technology, and there's so much change in the world, and the pandemic has ushered in so much change. And with change, when we don't understand it, when we can't embrace change, then fear comes.
That's right.
And how do you stay peaceful? How do you push fear to the curb and walk in the peace that passes all understanding at 83 years of age? Now, she said, she admitted that she was 83. I'm not blasting her.
No.
She told me that, and listen, when you get to be 83, you can tell the world. Okay, you should be telling the world. So how do you find that peace?
Well,
and how do you overcome fear?
Because I know that the Word of God says that He has not given us a spirit of fear. And so I just know if I'm starting to be fearful, it's not from God. It's from the other creature. And I say, Lord, thank You. You've given me the assurance of having. You give me sweet peace. And I just live by that.
Yeah. I want to talk about that assurance, because sometimes, you know, the enemy, in John 10:10, he has a plan, and he has a plot, and he has a ploy. And John 10:10 says that he has one mission, and that mission is to kill,
steal, and destroy.
But Jesus says, I've come that you might have life and have life more abundantly. I think it's the New Living Translation that says he has come to give us rich and satisfying life. That's the kind of life I want. And I can look at you and see that you're living the rich and satisfying life. And let's just make this plain, that it's not equated in dollars and cents, although He does supply all of our needs.
Yes, He does.
According to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus, right? But the rich and satisfying life is not just equated in dollars and cents.
Not at all.
So talk about that rich and satisfying life and how Jesus has given you the fruit of the Spirit. Okay, now this is how I remember the fruit of the Spirit. As a songwriter, one day I was wondering, God, you know, after all of this time, I have still not don't know all the fruit of the Spirit. And so He gave me a song. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness. Don't forget self-control. These are the fruit of the Spirit. So now I can remember.
I love it.
You love that?
Yes.
Dropped a little song in my spirit one day.
Yeah.
So talk about the fruit of the Spirit. Talk about how, you know, you've lived 83 years, 50 years in ministry. You've gone through some challenges.
Yes.
Even as a person of color, you've gone through challenges on stage. You've gone through challenges in your ministry. You've gone through challenges as a single woman. Talk about how you can. I've seen you love unconditionally. Love people who didn't look like you. Love people who are younger than you. Love people who are older than you. Talk about that love that God gives you and puts it in your heart.
Well, I always ask the Lord to make me like Him. I want to be like Jesus, and I know what His character was and what His mission was. And I just spend a lot of time. Of course, I have all kinds. I'll never forget this one thing. It was when you would go into a bank and you would get in like one line, sort of now you go here, you go in one line, then you can go here. So I'm in this one line and it was not moving. And I got up there and the name tag said trainee. So that made it even worse because my time was gonna be longer. So she could tell by my body language that I was not too happy. When she finished my transaction and I was walking away, she said, Miss Lily, I love you on those Gaither tapes.
It hit you right there in the spirit, didn't it?
I said, Lord, I needed this. Because now I know that I've got to be more like You, just have the patience to do what I need to do. And so that, things like that, that helped me in that area.
Yeah, I had a similar experience. A flight was canceled and I was on my way to do a concert and the flight was canceled. And everybody on the plane had to go back to the front desk and get rebooked. And you know how those travel days are just so inconvenient. Mm-hmm. And I was just going to unload on that agent when I got to that ticket counter. And I was just going to, how dare y'all? Don't y'all know I got places to go and people to see and things to do up in here? And when I stepped up to the counter and was ready to unload, I passed her my boarding pass. And she said, praise God, Babby Mason, I love your music. And I said, Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for reeling in that cord before I just, you know, let loose on and damage my testimony.
Yes.
So I thank God that he's able to do that. Yes. He's able to do that. So what is your hope for the future? Because this is what I love. The Bible says in Jeremiah 29, he's given us a future and a hope. Yes. So in the last minute that we have to talk, and you're going to sing some more for us, talk to us about that hope that you have for the future.
Well, I just want to be available to go and be where God wants me to be and when he wants me to be there. And so whatever he has planned is fine with me.
Yes.
As long as he keeps me healthy and I try to take care of myself so that I'm able to go and do and be.
Well, I want to pray for you.
Thank you.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for precious Lily. I thank you, Lord, for her testimony, how you've kept her well, how you've kept her in mind, body, soul, and spirit. Give her many more opportunities to minister to people around the world, including those who are watching this wonderful program. Bless her now in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Well, Lily is going to sing that iconic song that she delivers so beautifully. Welcome her back to sing His Eye is on the Sparrow.
Daddy says, we don't know what you're going through, but this song just assures you that if his eye's on the sparrow, he's going to take care of everything in your life. Said the robin to the sparrow, I would really like to know why these anxious human beings rush around and worry so. Said the sparrow to the robin, friend, I think it must be. Poor things, those human beings don't seem to have a heavenly father such as cares for you and me. Little birds talking about us. Let this song bless you as you listen to the words. Matthew 6:26 says, look at the birds of the air. They don't sow, they don't reap, they don't store away in barns, but your heavenly Father feeds them. And you are much more valuable than a little bird. So I ask you, why do you feel discouraged? Why? And why to the shadows come and why does your heart feel so lonely and long for heaven and home? Since Jesus is your portion, he's everything you need. Yeah. A constant friend, a constant friend is he. Folks, if his eye is on that little spirit, can say, I know he watches me. God's eye is on that little sparrow. So you can say, I know he watches. I sing because
I'm happy, yeah. I sing because Jesus Christ set us free when he died on Calvary. Aren't you proud as I? That old Cena is on the, it's on the sparrow, the little tiny sparrow. Growing up, we used to sing it a different way, so you can help me. Clap your hands and sing along. Everybody say, I sing because I'm happy. Whoa, and I sing because I'm free.
Because I'm free.
Oh, his eye is on the spirit.
I'll help you. You
so
just.
If I can skip.
Mm-hmm. You just take your time. No hurries, no worries. Well, I'm so happy that you have continued to watch the show and that hopefully and prayerfully you have been blessed. If your heart is like mine, your heart is full. And what a blessing Lily Knowles is to us today. So, Miss Lily, I get the opportunity to sing a little something with you. And I told our viewers that if they stuck around for the end of the show, we would give them a wonderful blessing.
And it's on the Gaither video.
Yeah, we recorded this song, Leave It There,
yes,
a few years ago.
Yes.
And I watched that video just the other day, and man, it's a blessing. It is such a blessing. So let's sing it together.
Yes.
You'll sing the first verse. You going to sing the first verse?
I will, yes.
All righty. Mm.
If the world from you withholds all of its silver and gold, and you have to get along with just meager fare, I've got good news for you. Jesus knows the pain you feel. He can save, Jesus can heal, but you gotta take your burden, take it to the Lord.
Hey.